Hello, good morning, y'all. Welcome to the sports segment here on New Day. My name is Yao Ofosu Labi. Now it's October 1, and you know it's just about 24 days more for the Ghana Football Association to decide who their next president will be, and also to chart a new course from now up until whenever the administration ends. This morning with me in the studio is one of the presidential aspirants who is an astute lawyer in the country. George Ankuma Mensah is one of the presidential aspirants there for the Ghana Football Association's position there. Sir, you're welcome.
It's a delight to be here.
A pleasure. Now, I mean, let's just begin. I mean, it's been a strenuous past few weeks for you, hasn't it?
It really has. We have begun the process of getting to see who the delegates are.
Right.
We have also begun with my team, obviously, putting in place strategies for launching our manifesto.
Amazing.
There is a lot of work to be done on the field.
Exactly.
And I am delighted to be part of this because it has to do with creating avenues for the young people,
right,
young women and men who are doing football in this country, so that we can have a great future.
Well, you've spoken about quite a lot. Now, from now up until the elections begin, do you think you have time to finish everything?
We will have to. And it doesn't take too much if you have the passion like I do.
Exactly.
And of course, I mean, now that you want to lead a corporate body like the Ghana Football Association, there's nothing like tiredness.
Right.
We are coming into the game with that kind of tenacity. There's going to be a new paradigm. Now, nobody is going to rest on their oars until we have delivered to the people.
Exactly.
And you know, football is a huge constituency.
Yeah.
I guess we are perhaps the biggest constituency in the country in terms of juveniles, mm-hmm, young men and women.
Mm-hmm. Now, Lea, you came into the scene, I mean, for the Ghana, the GFA presidential elections, and then you threw your hat in the ring. Not many people know you as someone who follows football actively. They know you as a lawyer, as someone who works in the legal system. But what are your ties with football? Just take us through it a bit.
Well, I have been doing a lot of football. I don't, if you check your records,
right,
I have been to this studio in 2015.
Yes.
When I was the lone person who wanted to contest against Nyantichi.
Yeah.
And that was a time that I brought out all these issues about non-transparency, mm-hmm, in the FA.
Yeah.
And I felt that they were not building enough structures to ensure that football became what it should be.
Right.
You remember, I can. Exactly. I think if you check your records.
Yeah.
So I have been a crusader, mm-hmm, behind the scenes.
Yeah.
And with my football experience, people do not know that my company sponsored the Black Maidens in their preparation for the World Cup in New Zealand, I think 2007, 2008.
Yeah.
My company took up the challenge.
Mm-hmm.
This is because we do things, you know, not because we want to be in the public eye.
Right.
We do things to help the young people,
mm-hmm,
and that is my greatest attribute.
Yeah.
I do things on the quiet so that young people will have a relief.
Yeah.
Now, I also own a third division team, Odoko Kwashima United.
I lived there when I was young.
Yeah, so you know that. You know them.
Yeah.
And when I came in, I have actually branded the team 9 years ago.
Okay.
And we are doing quite well.
Right.
We have changed the lives of a few people. So anybody who says that he doesn't know me in football, it's just because I am not at the forefront,
right,
as it should be.
Mm-hmm.
I should not interfere with the job of those who have been elected to do this. The job.
Yeah.
But now I am saying that we need to do a new paradigm, mm-hmm, in Ghana football.
Yeah.
There's got to be a revolution where we are running the FA like a corporate body.
Right.
And I've got loads of experience in corporate governance,
mm-hmm,
investment, commercial law,
yeah,
and I think I am the man for the job.
Now we'll come on to your plans for the Ghana Football Association, but I mean, it's after the whole number 12 issue and everything, a lot of questions have been raised about integrity. And so you have gone through the vetting process and everything. Did it meet the standard that you expected?
Well, I think I must commend the vetting committee. They have done a professional job as far as I saw it.
Yeah.
They have, for the first time, a governance and corporate aspect on the committee.
Right.
And they have four lawyers, I think, and, mm-hmm, then they have an astute businessman.
Right.
You know, this tells you where the direction of football is going.
Right.
And if you got there, you realize, you know, that the questioning in terms of the strategy for turning around the football is there. You can see that, you know, these are serious-minded people.
Exactly.
And I was for once delighted that the elections for the Ghana Football Association has taken this dimension. But that is not enough if we are not going to get the right person to run it. Because it could get worse. And I'm saying that, you know, we have come with that kind of experience so that Ghana football will begin to glow once again.
So what are the plans? Just outline the plans, lay down the plans for us.
For mine?
Yeah.
Well, I am coming with one of the biggest things. I think that, one, we must reform the Ghana Football Association in terms of transparency. Now, we are not transparent enough, and that is the reason we are not galvanizing the needed corporate sponsorships to let the game become what it should be.
Right.
Businessmen do not throw their money after bad people. Mm-hmm. They come with their brand and they expect that the collaboration with the brand in terms of your transparency and your acumen for marketing will be on point. Now, we haven't had that in the FA for a long time. So businesses are running from us when in fact they should be gravitating towards us because football is a market product and it's one of the local, one of the international brands which nobody can joke with. So this is the first one.
Yeah.
Now, secondly, we think that, you know, we have come with a development agenda to build the structures which are needed so that football will become a global brand, you know, in terms of our local scene.
Right.
Football, as you know, is association. That's why it's called association.
Mm-hmm.
We are taking it back to the communities.
Right.
We are going back into the communities where all the talents are. And we are ensuring that the community rivalry in football will engender that kind of business interest.
Right.
Then together, we can unearth talents for the game. You can tell from the way our teams are performing, our age group teams, under 17, we are not doing it because we are not getting the right people and we haven't put the structures in place.
Right.
Thirdly, we have come with hope. One may ask me, what does hope do in football? Hope for the young people is a serious prerequisite for gaining confidence in the young people that they can also do something. Now, if we can produce these young people from our communities to become icons, they become ambassadors for business. And through that, you know, you even improve the economic circumstances of the community. We have an elaborate plan to do this. And I think that the delegates should give us a nod.
Yeah.
We come with a background of investment. We come with a background of corporate practice, which we have done for 30 years.
Right.
And I have a great team. If you meet them, you will be surprised.
Right.
There are businesses who are ready to support the Ghana Football Association if they have the right person in place. And I guess that the delegates have seen and they have sensed that, you know, the situation at the moment calls for somebody with that kind of experience.
Now, lawyer, let's come to player welfare now. I mean, the players are central to what we do. I mean, I won't have a job now if there's no player.
Yeah.
You won't as well.
Yeah, sure.
And so for player welfare, how do we improve on the reward structure of players? And is that something you're looking to make better?
Yeah, sure.
If you're elected.
Sure. Our Premier League is nothing to write home about. I don't think it is professional at all. Because I think we went professional in 2008 or something. And I think that it is just the name that we acquired and put on ourselves. And we think that that would be the beginning of a revolution. No. Once the structures were not there, it wasn't going to happen.
Right.
I think that for starters, in order that we can keep the talents in Ghana for a while, we got to give them some kind of lease of life by giving them a stipend.
Okay.
Now, I know that now there's no money in the FA.
Yeah.
But you see, it will take time if you come into office to galvanize that kind of transparency so that businesses will begin to get interest in sponsorship.
Yeah.
And then you can raise revenue to pay them.
Yeah.
But I am saying that we are going to get them, at least Premier League, and we're going to give them some kind of, and we are going to pay them.
Right.
What we'll do is that we'll raise the money to pay the players. and then we will require accountability from the club owners.
Right.
You will be entitled to file your audit reports to us for continuous disbursement of the money to you.
Yeah.
Now, player welfare also doesn't just stop with the money. Insurance
exactly.
For their injuries.
Yeah.
We are also going to build a sports injury clinic.
Amazing.
Now, we need to do this, yeah. You know, if we are to go the next step in football.
Yeah.
And I think that if we even have a sports injury clinic in this country, mm-hmm. we will begin to become the international sports clinic for the West African sub-region.
Right.
Because there's none around.
Okay.
And if we get qualified doctors and surgeons, yeah, we will begin to. Our players suffer the same injuries as those in Europe.
Right.
And you see them, they tell you this player is out for 3 weeks because he's undertaking a minor surgery.
Mm-hmm.
Our players, the difference is that they keep the injury, it stays with them,
mm-hmm.
and that is why they are not able to play for long.
Yeah.
So this is how some of the snippets, and I'm giving you just a few because I haven't launched my manifesto
exactly,
yet.
Exactly.
And I'm going to tell you
yeah.
that these are things that we will do.
Now you mentioned that I mean you've helped women's football in
yeah.
your
yes.
own way,
yes.
but I mean over the years the women have been sidelined for quite some time. I mean you're looking to improve it in if you are elected, won't you?
Yes, I have said that you know the plan is going to be both men, both boys
and girls,
and girls
right.
men and women.
Yeah.
Our community program. Includes both young men and young women.
So we are looking at the formation of women's coach teams?
Yes. In fact, what we have dubbed it is that it's going to be a community champions league.
Right.
We are going to have a collaboration with the districts.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to channel some of the district social fund
right.
together with the FA's own funding
mm-hmm.
into football.
Right.
So that we are going to have a community a district football team.
Right.
At the same time, we are going to tackle schools and colleges.
Right.
We are going to have if there's there's a school in the district,
mm-hmm.
there's going to be rivalry in football
yes.
between the schools and colleges.
Yeah.
And then together, they will create a district team.
Yeah.
Now, we will then have a festival where they will play towards a regional final,
right.
culminating in a national final.
Yes.
By the time we are through with this, we have unearthed the talents for our age group teams.
Let's come to the Black Stars.
Yes.
Many people have lost interest in the team, mainly because a lot of people are spoken to say the Black Stars are paid astronomical figures and they do nothing.
Mm.
What do you make of the reward structure of the Black Stars? Is it too much?
Well, one of the things which is not making the Black Stars popular is that we are not, we do not know the players that come in because they don't come from the communities. We hear of people who have plied their trade, maybe they were born in Germany, and then we go and poach them. The reason we go and do that is that we find a quick fix to fix the Black Stars. Now, instead of generating the talents from the community so that they become community icons,
mm-hmm.
then people begin to love them.
Yeah.
Now, people do not love, they don't have any affinity to some of these players because they were born. I'm not saying that if we have an exceptional talent who is born in Europe, that we will not bring him into our team.
Right.
That's not what I'm saying
okay.
at all. But if we have equal and very serious guys in our communities who perhaps are better than these guys,
yeah.
and once we make them icons
mm-hmm.
and we bring them from the community follows them. That's what you find in England and other places where all the diplomats and all the expatriates I know in this country, they support the community team in their villages. They do not support the Arsenals and the Chelsea.
Right, right,
you find
true.
Somebody who says, look, I support something, Upton Town, you know, team,
right.
because that's where he was born.
Okay.
Now, in the process,
mm-hmm.
you create traditional teams.
Yeah.
Now, we don't have any traditional teams anymore, except for maybe Kotoko. You know what I mean, Hearts of Oak. Now, because we do not have these things, you know, people's affinity to these teams are not crystallized.
Right.
They see them, they are just part of the landscape. But we are going to create a situation where we get experts to design how to create community teams.
To whip up the interest.
Yes, to whip up the interest.
Yeah.
Now, you should be able to tell when they say a team is from Tamale,
mm-hmm.
from even their jersey,
right.
like Newcastle. I mean, nobody tells you this is a Newcastle jersey. Now, we are not going to allow teams to just go and buy a Chelsea look-alike jersey and use it to play in our Premier League. Right. We are not going to allow that.
Right.
We are going to sit with them, support them, technically devise a system where you will fashion out your colors from your community using community symbols and totems.
Right.
You know, so that you become part of the community for purposes of engendering interest in football. This is what you need to do if you want to succeed. And it's a football is a large-scale business. If you don't have this kind of acumen, you will just come and do business as usual. This is not what we have come to do.
Great. Big, big plans there from lawyer George Ankoma Mensah, my guest in the studio this morning. But lawyer, when is the manifesto launch?
We are looking to launch it maybe on the 9th or 10th.
Okay.
Because there's a little clash, you know, in one of those days, we have done some adjustment. But right. By the end of this week, we should be able to announce the date.
Well, one of your... how do I call it? Competitors is launching his manifesto today. Will you be there?
I think because
you were not at the previous one.
Yes, I wasn't there. Yeah. I think I will be there this time to support him. We must support ourselves.
Exactly.
And I have said that I will work with everybody because everybody is relevant.
Okay.
In the game of football.
Now, lawyer, a final message to your delegates.
Well, my final message to my dear delegates is that I am in the same soup as you are. I have invested in football for the past 9 years, but I am not getting a policy maker from the FA to streamline football in such a way that I will be the beneficiary, and the beneficiary will be the children that we are bringing up. Now is the time that we mustn't look at faces, but we must look at competence and vision. I have come to you asking you to give me this mandate because I have cultivated a certain vision which I have nurtured for 30 years in my field of endeavor, which I'm bringing to bear so that you will become the beneficiary. Football will change once and for all, and you would not recognize it in 4 years.
Well, that's Lawyer George Ankoma Mensah there. Lawyer, thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Thank you very much.
And all the best. All the best as well.
Thank you. I need all the luck.
Also, on the 25th of October is the Ghana Football Association's presidential elections. There should be really, really heated. But here on New Day, on the sports segment, we say goodbye to you. We'll